वहाँ पे तीन आपकी एम्पायर्स हैं, डायनेस्टीज हैं, भामनी है, देन यू हैव विजयनगर, देन यू हैव द गजपति रूलर्स.
एग्जैक्टली.
तो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट तो वो बनता है.
द डेक्कन सुल्तान एज़ वेल.
वो भामनी द डेक्कन सुल्तान द रूलर्स. हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू तारीख एंड वेलकम टू आवर स्पेशल सेगमेंट कॉल्ड तारीख क्लासेस फॉर क्लास 12th हिस्ट्री. एंड द चैप्टर फॉर टुडे इज एन इंपीरियल कैपिटल विजयनगर circa 14th to 16th century. विजयनगर का मतलब है अ सिटी ऑफ विक्ट्री एंड दिस हैज बीन गिवन दिस नेम हैज बीन गिवन टू द एम्पायर एज वेल एज द प्लेस. आज के दौर में विजयनगर एम्पायर के बारे में काफ़ी लोगों को जानकारी है ऑल्सो बिकॉज ऑफ अ प्लेस कॉल्ड हम्पी विच यू नो वहाँ पे टूरिज्म बहुत ग्रो किया है एंड दैट यूज टू बी द वन ऑफ द मेजर प्लेसेस ऑफ द होल एम्पायर. इट वॉज अ एम्पायर दैट हैड वेरियस डायनेस्टीज. Like you have Delhi Sultanate and you have dynasties. You have the Mamluk dynasty, then you have Khilji dynasty, then you have Tughlaq dynasty. Similarly, Vijayanagar Empire में भी ये एक dynasty थी, empire था जिसके अंदर dynasties थी. जो stretch था इस empire का, that was from the river Krishna in the north to the southern tip of the southern peninsula. It was founded in the 14th century and somewhere in 1565 it the city was sacked, the empire was sacked and initially 17th-18th century mein it got deserted and pure ruins mein bhi ye ho gaya tha, ye jagah ho gayi thi. What we know, well, when people were researching about this place, jo archaeological evidence thi aur jo oral traditions thi, inscriptions thi ya kisi traveler ke accounts the, through that the scholars could you know write about this place and write the history of this particular empire. Jo name Hampi bhi hai, that has been derived from their you know local goddess called Pamba Devi. And this place has been one of the UNESCO World Heritage Sites. So because we know about this place and Vijayanagar Empire ke mein pata chala, to uski aur bhi jo you know it has the popularity has grown over a period of time. The first topic is discovery of Hampi. The ruins of Hampi were brought to light somewhere in the 1800s when you know an engineer named and an antiquarian named Colonel Colin McKenzie. He was you know an employee of the East India Company and he had reached that particular place and that's how people he got to know and the English East India Company they got to know about that place and he also you know drafted a map of that particular site. Somewhere in 1856, photographers they went and they clicked photos of the monuments. They started, you know, collecting material of that place. In 1836, epigraphists they started collecting inscriptions to reconstruct the history. Then historians were there who used these inscriptions, detail on the monuments, and other finds of that place to reconstruct the past. They also kind of you know they wanted to gain information from the priest of the Virupaksha temple and also the priest of the goddess Pamba Devi's temple. So unke oral traditions jo the jo generations se passed on the, so they got information through that. And also travelers who traveled, foreign travelers, indigenous travelers who traveled to that place, and their accounts were also used, and other works that were written in Telugu, Tamil, Kannada and Sanskrit.
The second topic is Rayas, Nayakas and Sultans. Now, according to tradition and also through epigraphic evidence, we know that the Vijayanagara Empire was founded in 1336 by two brothers, Harihara and Bukka. Now, throughout the history of Vijayanagara Empire, it kept including a variety of regions that covered different languages in different regions under the empire, and the borders kept fluctuating. Now, throughout that time, they were in constant tussle between the Deccan sultans and also the Gajapati rulers from Orissa. And they had a constant tussle because who would cover the river valley, because the river valley was very fertile and also it led to lucrative trade opportunities. So उसके चलते दोनों और तीनों फैक्शंस में वो तू तू मैं मैं टाइप होता रहता था. बट थ्रू दिस ऑल्सो देर वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ इंटरैक्शन दैट टुक प्लेस एंड अ लॉट ऑफ आइडियाज़ वर ऑल्सो चेंज्ड दैट द विजयनगर एम्पायर सॉर्ट ऑफ अब्सॉर्ब्ड विद इन इट्स फोल्ड. एंड द मोस्ट टेलिंग फीचर इज दैट ऑफ द आर्किटेक्चर विच वी विल कवर लेटर इन द चैप्टर. और आर्किटेक्चर की ही अगर हम बात करें तो व्हेन वी सी इन द साउथ there were powerful chiefdoms, whether you consider the Cholas from Tamil Nadu or the Hoysalas from Karnataka, and they had built elaborate religious structures during that time. And during the Vijayanagara Empire, you just see them add on to these temples. For example, Rajaraja Chola the first built the Brihadishwara temple in Thanjavur, and Vishnu Vardhana built the Chennakeshava temple, which is in Bellur, and both of them were very powerful structures during that time. And during the Vijayanagara Empire, they just kept adding to the structures to make it grander. Now, of course, we are talking about pre-modern era, jahan pe aapke state lines were not established and democracy wasn't really established, and your empires fluctuated, and there was constant warfare with each other, with your neighboring empires or tribes and all that. And during this time, it was very important for you to be a military power in your own right. And us time pe, it was very important for the Vijayanagara Empire to have an effective cavalry. Cavalry is basically horse riders, ghursawar, and they add to the military strength of any empire. And horses aren't native to India.
Yeah.
And so it was very important that the horses were coming in, because they were an effective tool, and they were generally brought in through the Arab traders who came from Central Asia. Although local traders were also dealing with it, they were called the Kudirai Chetis, and they were also participating in the horse trade. 1498 mein there were more players jo is scene mein aaye, and this was the introduction of the Portuguese to the Vijayanagara Empire, and they brought with them muskets, and that was a great tool, and it gave the Portuguese also a bit of an importance, and they came, they established their trading centers and they established their military stations, and they also contributed greatly to the पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ दिस रीजन विच वॉज ऑलरेडी वेरी मर्की. मतलब आपका चलता रहता था किसी ना किसी के साथ झगड़ा, एंड दे कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू दैट
फॉर ऑब्वियस रीजन, बिकॉज वहाँ पे तीन आपकी एम्पायर्स हैं, डायनेस्टीज है, भामनी है, देन यू हैव विजयनगर, देन यू हैव द गजपति रूलर.
एग्जैक्टली.
तो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट तो
वो बनता है, द डेक्कन सुल्तान
एज़ वेल. वो भामनी था, डेक्कन सुल्तान थे. कॉन्फ्लिक्ट तो जाहिर सी बात है, क्योंकि यू हैव द थ्री यू नो रूलिंग डायनेस्टीज, यू नो यू हैव द बहामनी किंगडम, जो डेक्कन सुल्तान्स, देन यू हैव विजयनगर एम्पायर, देन यू हैव द गजपति रूलर्स. एंड तीनों एक दूसरे से मतभेद तो करते ही रहेंगे, बिकॉज दे वर सो क्लोज टू ईच अदर, दे वर लाइक शेयरिंग द बॉर्डर, दैट वॉज फॉर ऑब्वियस रीजन. थे ऑल्सो वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड हियर इज दैट कहते हैं कि जो विजयनगर के किंग्स होते थे वो लोग सुपारी और पान का पत्ते के ऊपर लेके नेबरिंग एम्पायर, नेबरिंग स्टेट्स में भेजते थे. तो अगर वो एक्सेप्ट कर लिया जाता था, दैट मीन्स यू आर देयर फ्रेंड. अगर एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया जाता था, तब उनका जो रैथ है, जो उनकी फेस द रैथ और द वॉर विद द विजयनगर किंग्स. तो कहते हैं द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सुपारी देना has come from the Vijayanagar Empire.
But the Vijayanagar Empire was not only known for distributing supari. They were also very well known for trading in spices and jewelries and precious stones. And that is also something that drew in a lot of income, which in turn made the Vijayanagar Empire very prosperous. So it was an empire where people were used to luxury.
Within the polity, the claimants to power contained of the ruling lineage, then the military commanders were there, and इन्हीं के बीच में conflict चलती रहती थी to gain the prominence or to gain the throne. तो जो फर्स्ट जो डायनेस्टी थी जो विजयनगर एम्पायर की थी वो संगम डायनेस्टी थी एंड दे हैड दे कंसोलिडेट एंड दे हैड दे पावर टिल 1485. दे वर सप्लांटेड बाय द सलुवा डायनेस्टी टिल 1503 एंड देन बाय द तुलुवा डायनेस्टी एंड उनके जो सबसे फेमस रूलर हैं वो हैं कृष्णदेव राय जिनके कहते हैं कि उनका जो टाइम पीरियड था एंड उनकी जो जो डायनेस्टी थी दैट वॉज ऑफ कंसोलिडेशन एंड पीस एंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी एंड ऑल्सो कृष्णदेव राय इज़ फेमस बिकॉज ही हैड अ मिनिस्टर हु वॉज रियली फेमस एंड ही वॉज कॉल्ड तनाली. कृष्णदेव राय का जो रूल है वो एक्सपेंशन भी दिखाता है. द रीजन बिटवीन तुंगभद्रा एंड रिवर कृष्णा सो दैट इज़ नोन एज द रायचूर द्वार. दे कंसोलिडेटेड दैट समवेयर. द गजपति रूलर्स वर ऑल्सो डिफीटेड बाय देम बाय कृष्णदेव राय स्पेशली एंड जो जो सुल्तान्स थे जो डेक्कन सुल्तान्स थे उनको भी कहीं ना कहीं ही शोड हिज पावर बट स्टिल तीनों के बीच में वो मिलिट्री प्रिपेयर्डनेस रहती ही थी क्योंकि कभी भी कॉन्फ्लिक्ट कभी भी वॉर हो सकती है या होती रहती थी उनके बीच में. कृष्णदेव राय हैज़ ऑल्सो बीन मैंशनड वेन इट कम्स टू यू नो एडिंग फाइन टेम्पल्स इन द किंगडम. He was also known for adding Gopurams on the temple. He also founded a suburban township near Vijayanagar called Nagalapuram after his mother. And जो हम descriptions देखते हैं विजयनगर empire की जो detail में देखते हैं वो कृष्णदेव राय के time पर ही आती है या उनके बाद आती है. Strain began to emerge in the empire after कृष्णदेव राय's death in 1529. And जो उनके successors थे they were you know kind of troubled by the military chief of the Nayaks. 1542 mein the empire was again shifted to another dynasty of Aravidu and they remained at power by the end of the 17th century. Is time ke period mein power politics and jo status alignment hoti thi wo change hoti rehti thi between the sultanate and the Vijayanagar empire. And this was a period of that whole that chaos, you know, whenever the empire is diminishing or getting ruined, so that instability you can see. So this was that period, the end of the 17th century. Now because changing alignments thi, because of the conflict, that increasing conflict between the sultanates and the Vijayanagar Empire, also the Bahamani Sultanate, which was one sultanate, had also, it got divided into five sultanates. सो उनके बीच में भी अलायंस बनती रहती थी अगेंस्ट द विजयनगर एम्पायर. तो इन 1565 राम राय ही वेंट इनटू द वॉर विद द कंबाइंड फोर्सेस ऑफ बीजापुर सल्तनत अहमदनगर एंड गोलकोंडा एंड द प्लेस वॉज राक्षसी तंगड़ी ऑल्सो नोन एज तालीकोट एंड ही वॉज डिफीटेड. तो उसके बाद द सिटी जो विजयनगर एम्पायर जो सिटी थी मेन दैट वॉज sacked by the winning forces, जो ये जो combined सल्तनत की forces थी.
I think I'll give a disclaimer in the beginning that
we are North Indians and we don't know how to pronounce. So Vijayanagar after the defeat, Vijayanagar की city deserted हो गई थी and focus east की तरफ shift हो गया था जहाँ के जो Aravidu थे वो they were ruling there and from a place called Penukonda and then later from Chandragiri which is near Tirupati. But विजयनगर एम्पायर के जो किंग्स थे और जो सल्तनत के किंग्स थे जो बहामनी किंगडम एंड लेटर ऑन दी यू नो डिसइंटीग्रेटेड फाइव सल्तनत्स इट वाज नॉट ऑलवेज होस्टाइल. मेनी टाइम्स यू नो विजयनगर किंग जैसे कृष्णदेव राय थे ही ट्राइड टू इंटरवीन वेन एवर देवर हॉस्टिलिटीज और क्योस इन द सल्तनत एंड ऑल्सो द सुल्तान्स वुड इंटरवीन जब विजयनगर एम्पायर स्पेशली कृष्णदेव राय के बाद जब you know chaos much gaya tha ki who would be the next ruler so they try to intervene so sometimes they would try to balance each other out you know ki bhai chaos hota tha kahin aur so they would try to you know solve that like Krishnadev Rai many times helped the sultan yeah. you know the Bahamani sultans aur Bijapur ke sultans the wo the क्योस बाद में अभी इसलिए मचा था राम राय के टाइम पे बिकॉज राम राय ट्राइड टू यू नो इंटरफेयर इन various sultanates trying to put one sultan against the other. So that is why the sultans combined themselves and they fought a war against Ram Raya. Already peace tha, but they wanted to create chaos, this guy Ram Raya. So ye चलता रहता था विजयनगर एम्पायर.
अब नायक्स की हम बात कर रहे थे कि कभी वो रिबेल कर जाते थे, तो हु वर दे? बेसिकली नायक्स वर मिलिट्री कमांडर्स एंड दे जनरली कंट्रोल्ड फोर्ट्स एंड हैड ऑल्सो आर्म्ड सपोर्टर्स एंड सम ऑफ देम वुड मूव फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस एंड उनके साथ कभी कभी पेजेंट्स भी मूव करते थे इन सर्च फॉर फर्टाइल लैंड्स. नाउ द नायक्स वर जनरली तेलुगु स्पीकर्स और कन्नडा स्पीकर्स एंड दे वुड ऑल्सो सबमिट टू the Rayas, but sometimes they would also rebel and then unke khilaf military action karna padta tha to subdue them. Ab zahir si baat hai, if military commanders have so much power with them, they control forts and they have armed personnels with them, they are also a source of problem, and to subdue them to a certain extent, the Amara Nayaka system was introduced. Now this system is very similar to the Ikta system of the Delhi Sultanate, in which the Raya of the Vijayanagara Empire would bestow certain territories to these military commanders, and the Nayaks would effectively govern these territories in lieu of the Raya, and he had the right to collect taxes from the peasants and artisans and the population and keep a portion of it for himself, either for personal use or to maintain his army and elephants, and the rest would be given to the Raya. And along with the taxes, the Amara Nayakas would also visit the Raya periodically to express their fealty, to express their loyalty, and also bestow gifts upon the Raya. It was very important for the Raya to have a good military system, and the Nayaks also contributed in that, and it is through their contribution that virtually the entire peninsula was under the Vijayanagara Empire. But by the 17th century, the Nayakas became more confident, and although previously unko transfer kiya jata tha, but by the 17th century they started to maintain their independent territories, became stronger, and then eventually that also led to the downfall of the Vijayanagara Empire.
Because postings were important. Even jab hum Mughal time dekhenge, you have the Jagirdars, Mansabdars, to जो मनसबदार होते थे उनकी पोस्टिंग्स रहती थी. क्यों एक जगह पे वो नहीं चाहता था, जो सुल्तान है या किंग है, कि वो एक जगह पे टिके रहे? क्योंकि क्या होता है कि देन यू स्टार्ट मेकिंग योर बेस वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, यू स्टार्ट मेकिंग, आप अपना उस एरिया को जान जाते हो, यू अपनी आप एक ग्राउंड वर्क शुरू कर देते हो, यू स्टार्ट बिकमिंग मोर पावरफुल
एंड ऑल्सो रिसोर्सेज,
लॉयल्टी ऑफ द पीपल. तो इसलिए पोस्टिंग्स वर इम्पोर्टेंट. तो सिमिलरली नायक्स की भी पोस्टिंग इम्पोर्टेंट थी, ताकि वो अपनी स्ट्रॉन्ग होल्ड उस जगह पे ना, उस चीज़ में कामयाब ना हो. विजयनगर द कैपिटल एंड द एनवायरनमेंट. सो हर एक एम्पायर का एक अपना, एक स्पेशली कैपिटल्स का जो उस एम्पायर का था, उनका एक अपना फिजिकल लेआउट होता है, एक अपना एक यू नो बिल्डिंग स्टाइल होती है. तो विजयनगर एम्पायर में जो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ थी वाटर रिसोर्सेज, एंड वाटर सोर्सेज ऐसे थी कि वो एक नेचुरल बेसिन फॉर्म करती थी विजयनगर में, स्पेशली क्योंकि जो तुंगभद्रा रिवर थी वो नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न डायरेक्शन में फ्लो करती थी. दिस एरिया वाज आल्सो सराउंडेड बाय ग्रेनाइट हिल्स, जो एक गर्डल टाइप, यू नो इट फॉर्म्ड अ गर्डल अराउंड द सिटी. देन एंड और इसी जो ग्रेनाइट के जो हिल्स थे, वहाँ से पानी फ्लो करता था एम्पायर के अंदर. जहाँ भी स्ट्रीम्स होती थी वहाँ पे रिजर्वॉयर्स बनाए जाते थे, यू नो, बिकॉज दिस एरिया वाज वेरी एरिड. एंड वी हैव नॉट, लाइक वी पर्सनली हैव नॉट बीन टू हम्पी, बट वी हैव बीन टू द सीट ऑफ द बामनी किंगडम, एंड दैट एरिया वाज आल्सो वेरी एरिड. इट रिमाइंड्स यू ऑफ समवेयर ऑफ राजस्थान, बिकॉज आपको वहाँ पर भी वही ड्राइनेस दिखती है जैसे आप राजस्थान में देखते हो. एंड यू सी कॉटन प्लांटेशन देयर,
सो नॉट रेगिस्तान टाइप्स, बट लाइक
इट्स वेरी ड्राई एंड एरिड, बिकॉज ये एरिड जोन्स थी. तो एम्बैंकमेंट्स तो बनाते थे, दे ऑल्सो हैड वाटर टैंक सिस्टम. तो वाटर टैंक्स और रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग भी बहुत की जाती थी, सो दैट इरीगेशन पर्पसेस के लिए. सो इन द अर्ली ईयर्स ऑफ द 15th सेंचुरी कमलापुरम टैंक वॉज कंस्ट्रक्टेड, सो दैट कैन बी द वाटर कैन बी, यू नो, थ्रू चैनल्स कैन बी स्प्रेड टू द एरियाज, टू द वेयर कल्टिवेशन वुड टेक प्लेस, एंड ऑल्सो रॉयल सेंटर्स में भी वो जाता था। फिर जब संगम डायनेस्टी जो इनिशियल डायनेस्टी थी उस टाइम पे भी एक हिरिया कनाल होता था एंड दैट कनाल इट्स नाउ इन रूइंस बट दैट कनाल वाटर वाज यूज्ड टू यू नो इरिगेट द लैंड बिटवीन द अर्बन कोर एंड द सेक्रेट सेंटर्स। तो द सिस्टम ऑफ वाटर टैंक वाज आल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज ऑफ हाउ द टोपोग्राफी एंड हाउ द क्लाइमेट वाज इन दैट पीरियड एंड इवन टुडे। अब्दुल रजाक gives us some description about the fortification and how the roads were in the Vijayanagar Empire and in the city Vijayanagar jo main hai and he was really impressed by the fortifications. So there were walls that encircled not only the forts but also the agricultural lands. Fortifications thi aur 7 lines of forts hoti thi. जो ये फोर्टिफिकेशंस थी जो वॉल थी दे वर नॉट ओनली इनसर्कल द फोर्ट बट ऑल्सो द एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड्स एंड हिंटर लैंड्स जो थी। द आउटरमोस्ट वॉल कनेक्टेड द हिल्स विद द सिटी एंड जो मेसनरी जो यूज़ की गई थी दैट वॉज टेपर्ड एंड ब्लॉक्स थे दे वर वेज शेप ब्लॉक्स दैट वर यू नो नो सीमेंट वॉज यूज वो एक दूसरे के ऊपर लगा के द इनर साइड अटका देते थे एंड अंदर अंदर रबल यूज़ किया जाता था रबल मेसनरी यूज़ की जाती थी सीमेंट नहीं यूज़ किया जाता था उस टाइम पर। एंड अब्दुल रजाक कहते हैं जो फर्स्ट सेकेंड और थर्ड वॉल है उसके बीच में यू कैन सी फील्ड्स एंड गार्डन्स एंड हाउसेस सो दैट मेड इट वेरी ब्यूटीफुल सीनिकली। पेज जो थे ही वाज अ पोर्चुगीज ही वाज फ्रॉम पोर्चुगल एंड ही वाज अ पार्ट ऑफ द विजयनगर कोर्ट। So he also mentions that from the first circuit and when you enter the city there is a great distance wahan pe aap rice fields dekhenge you will also see water you know water being used because rice requires a lot of water and the water that was used came from two lakes and ye jo information historians ko milti thi they actually found evidence when they were you know digging up the place that they found especially between the urban core and the sacred center they found these agricultural tracts aur jo pani tha wahan pe wo tungabhadra se jo wahan dam thi wahan se pani laya jata tha to for irrigation purposes but what makes the Vijayanagar empire ka jo ye system tha where the agricultural lands were also fortified is because whenever there would be sieges or you know a neighboring state is or the neighboring empire is going to you know
lay a siege or attack
your empire the us time pe they would cut off the enemy ruler would or the enemy the enemy would cut off the person they were attacking so they would completely cut them off to usse kya hota tha ki jab bhi jo aapka ration hai ya you jo khane peene ki cheeze wo aapki bilkul band ho jati thi uske liye kya karte the jo rulers the they would always have these granaries where they would store the ration you know for consumption because these sieges would take months and years at times but the Vijayanagar kings they thought of something more elaborate and expensive they started fortifying the agricultural lands also ki aap to bhai hum pe hamla karte raho
tension hi
jo hamare paas to khana hai kafi karte raho second line of fortification it went around the inner core of the urban complex aur jo third line thi wo jo sacred center the royal center tha usko cover karta tha एंड स्पेशली जो मेजर बिल्डिंग होती थी उनकी भी अपनी हाई वॉल्स होती थी सो द सिटी मतलब इमेजिन कर अगर हम करें तो कैसे फोर्टिफाइड थी हर एक फ्रॉम द हिल्स द आउटरमोस्ट वहाँ पे फोर्टिफिकेशन था देन यू हैव द एग्रीकल्चरल ट्रैक्ट्स एंड कनाल्स एंड देन यू हैव अराउंड द अर्बन सेंटर्स देन यू हैव अराउंड द रॉयल सेंटर्स
लाइक बेसिकली सेवन लेयर्स ऑफ प्रोटेक्शन
या
I mean, for the royal family for the royal seven
but yeah. even urban centers and people houses were also there in the within the fortification the fort was entered through a well guarded and elaborate gateway and which connected the city to the road the gate was a very very elaborate and it had an arch and also a dome on top of that so this was a typical feature that was introduced in the subcontinent by the Turkish sultans तो जहाँ पे आपका आर्च होता है एंड आपका ऊपर डोम है एंड दिस इज़ द साइन ऑफ इंडो इस्लामिक आर्किटेक्ट। architecture. Archaeologists also studied the roads that connected the whole empire, the city. So you have various roads there, and जो सबसे elaborate important roads होते थे वो जो sacred centers और temples से गुजरते थे और उनके आसपास bazaars लगाए जाते थे, because obviously you would have bazaars lined up जहाँ पे भी sacred center होता था. जब हम urban core की बात करते हैं तो archaeological evidence बहुत कम है, it's really less, because जो houses of the people they have not they don't exist anymore, the common people's houses they don't exist anymore. But in the northeastern part of the urban core, archaeologists have found remains of porcelain, so that means rich traders could have settled there. They also found settlements of Muslim population, because when we find tombs and mosques, but their architecture resembles that of the mandapas which were found in the temples of Hampi. So this guy, there was a person by the name of Barbosa who had visited the empire in the 16th century. He was from Portugal, and he mentions about the houses of the ordinary people, and he says that they were thatched houses, but well-built houses and lined according to the occupation, and the streets had many open places also. Field surveys indicate that the entire area was dotted with temples and places of worship. That means there were different cults and different communities that were settled and who worshipped their the gods they worshipped. And there were also water tanks in that area. There were also wells, rainwater tanks, temple tanks that acted as a source for the people that were settled there.
The next topic is the Royal Center. Now, this section in the settlement that is called the Royal Center, it is located in the northwestern part of the settlement. And the curious case about this is that there are nearly 60 temples. So although this is the royal center where the palaces and secular buildings are supposed to be located, there are over 60 temples, and this hints at the possibility that the ruling class would try to gain patronage from a variety of deities. So whoever had cultic significance within the population that they were governing, they would try to get their loyalty through the gods that they worshipped. And so over 60 temples were located in this settlement. Apart from the 60 temples, 30 buildings have been identified as palaces. Now what makes these 30 buildings are of a secular nature, and why they are called secular is because they don't seem to include materials that would have used for that would have been used for ritualistic purposes. Jaise aapko temples mein milta hai ya aapko platform milega ya fir just spaces that were designated for rituals are missing in these nearly 30 buildings. And another difference is that the temples were made out of stone and materials that would not perish over time, whereas these more secular buildings, whether they be palaces or whatever, they were built out of perishable materials. So you have the foundations, but you don't really have the structure of those.
Yeah, because I think they were made of wood.
Yeah. Now, depending on the location and the size and the shape of the structures, historians have sort of identified a few places, or they've tried to identify a few places, and they've tried to assign functions to them. So there's one such enclosure, which is the largest enclosure, and it is called the King's Palace. Now this structure, the King's Palace in itself, is it's just remarkable because of its size. There is nothing that suggests that it was occupied by royalty. Ab kafi bada structure hai, it has huge double walls running across the entire complex, and there is a street that goes in between them. And it is significant because it houses two major platforms which are of importance. One is called the Audience Hall and the other is called the Mahanavami Dibba. Ab Audience Hall ki agar hum baat kare, to it is a platform that has a space designated for wooden pillars, and there is also through the structure you can see that there is space made for a staircase that possibly leads to a first floor building. Now the pillars itself, they are very closely spaced to each other, and although it is called the Audience Hall, because of the placement of the pillars, and we are not exactly sure कि पिलर्स अगर सारे स्लॉट्स में यूज़ किए गए थे कि बस डेजिग्नेटेड था कि मतलब वी आर नॉट एग्जैक्टली अवेयर ऑफ द एंटायर करेक्ट planning of the hall. So we are not fully sure about the purpose of that building. So it is called the audience hall. But if you were to consider the slots for the wooden pillars, they are very close together to enable a large gathering of people. और महानवमी डिब्बे की अगर हम बात करें तो इट इज़ लोकेटेड एट वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट पॉइंट्स इन द सेटलमेंट एंड इट कवर्ड एन एरिया ऑफ अप टू 11,000 स्क्वायर फीट एंड उसकी जो हाइट थी दैट वेंट अप टू 40 फीट. देर इज एविडेंस दैट दिस प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ द महानवमी डिब्बा इट सपोर्टेड अ सेकेंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ वुड ऑन टॉप एंड वॉट इज लेफ्ट अपार्ट फ्रॉम द प्लेटफॉर्म आर द रिलीफ कार्विंग्स ऑन इट. अब महानवमी इज़ ए वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट डे इन द हिंदू कैलेंडर ऑफ फेस्टिवल्स एंड इट इज़ नोन एज इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ द नाइन्थ डे सेलिब्रेशंस दैट आर नोन थ्रू आउट द कंट्री बाय वेरियस नेम्स, या तो दशहरे के नाम से, नवरात्रि, महानवमी, दुर्गा पूजा. एंड इट इज़ वेरी लाइकली दैट द सेलिब्रेशंस दैट दिस महानवमी डिब्बा हैड एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल टू प्ले इन द सेलिब्रेशंस ऑफ महानवमी. Had a very important role to play in the celebration of Mahanavami. Now, the celebrations during this time would include the ritual worship of the idol or the image, along with the worship of the chief horse, processions and performances by artisans and dancers and musicians.
And the Navratri that has been mentioned here is the one that happens in September, October.
Celebrations would also include processions of decorated horses and elephants and other animals, along with men, women, maybe even soldiers, and they would be presented to the king and his guests by the Nayaks and maybe even subordinate kings, and they would come and they would present the king, the Raya, with a lot of gifts as a symbol of their fealty to loyalty and also as a part of the celebration.
Like how you peshkash.
But if we have to consider the entire celebration that was a part of Mahanavami, is it possible that the celebrations were held at or around the Mahanavami Dibba? Because historians have also speculated that if you have to consider the quantity of people and animals and women, children, guests that were included in such celebrations, it might not have been possible for that to be held at the Mahanavami Dibba. So once again, like the audience hall, it is not clear what this structure was used for, like exactly what was the significance.
Just basic assumptions.
Even if it was used for Mahanavami, like maybe that was a name that stuck.
Yeah.
But for all we know, it was used for other purposes.
Yeah.
So again, that is something that is maybe lost to time or it is up to speculation. Now talking about buildings that might have been not named accurately, there is the structure that is called the Lotus Mahal. Now this is a name that was given by British travelers, so that's not the original name, and historians are again not very confident about the purpose of the structure. It is a beautiful structure, but exactly what was this used for? Now Colin McKenzie, in one of the maps, he has suggested that maybe this was a place where the Council of Ministers met, where the Raya met his Nayaks or other ministers. That is also because there is something that is akin to a stable for elephants that is located very close to the Lotus Temple. Mahal.
Lotus Temple is in Delhi, New Delhi. It's called Bahai Temple also.
It's shaped like a lotus. Now, of the 60 temples, there is one temple which is maybe the most magnificent in the royal center, and that is called the Hazara Rama Temple. Now it is likely that this temple was only meant to be used by the royal family and not everybody. The main idols are lost, but what is left are the relief panels on the temple, and they describe scenes from the Ramayana. Of course, when we talk about the city of Vijayanagara, when it was sacked, a lot of buildings were destroyed. But what continued through the Nayaks who then rose to power was the building of grand structures. So that is something that continued even after the Vijayanagar Empire.
The next topic is sacred center. So now we will move to the northern part of the empire, where Tungabhadra River is. इस ये एरिया रॉकी है एंड इट हैज़ हिल्स. तो कहते हैं इन द एंशंट टाइम्स जो मंकी किंगडम था बाली और सुग्रीव का, वो यहीं सिचुएटेड था, एंड जो कि रामायण में काफ़ी इम्पॉर्टेंट प्ले है, उनको रोल प्ले किया गया उन्होंने. एंड कुछ ट्रेडिशंस ये बताते हैं कि जो रॉकी एरिया है यहाँ पे जो इनकी गॉडेस है, जो डेइटी है, लोकल डेइटी है, जो पंपा देवी, शी अटेन पेनेंस एंड शी वांटेड टू मैरी विरूपक्षा हु इज़ द गार्डियन डेइटी ऑफ द प्लेस हु इज़ नन अदर देन लॉर्ड शिवा. आज भी इस विरूपक्षा टेम्पल के अंदर एनुअली पंपा देवी और विरूपक्षा की शादी की सेलिब्रेशंस होती हैं. इन हिल्स में वी विल ऑल्सो फाइंड जैन टेम्पल्स विच वर द प्री विजयनगर टेम्पल. सो दैट मीन्स दैट दिस एरिया हैज़ बिन अ सीक्रेट प्लेस सिंस अ वेरी सिंस इवन बिफोर द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द विजयनगर एम्पायर. टेम्पल बिल्डिंग इन दिस रीजन हैड स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस एम्पायर. जब पलवास थे, वी हैड चोलास, वी हैड चालुक्यास, वी हैड होयसालास, तब से ही टेम्पल बिल्डिंग शुरू हुई थी. टेम्पल कंस्ट्रक्ट करना एक किंग का धर्म होता था, बिकॉज ही दैट वॉज इन अ वे यू आर एसोसिएटिंग योर सेल्फ विद द डिवाइन एंड यू आर काइंड ऑफ एसोसिएटिंग योर सेल्फ विद गॉड एंड यू नो दैट आई एम द रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ गॉड ऑन अर्थ. द रूलर विल ऑल्सो गिव ग्रांट्स एंड रिसोर्सेज व्हेन इट कम्स टू मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द टेम्पल एंड दीज टेम्पल्स बिकेम इकोनॉमिक्स बिकेम अ प्लेस वे यू नो इकोनॉमिक social political life grew and it became important and religiously also this place became very important. Rulers ke point of view se maintaining a temple, renovating a temple, constructing a temple was something that you would gain through that you will gain support of the people, you will gain recognition, wealth and piety. It is likely that Vijayanagar empire became was situated in this region, or they chose this place because already the shrine of Pampa Devi and Virupaksha existed, so they chose the sacred site. And also Vijayanagar kings kind of showed themselves as the the god Virupaksha, as they're associated with god Virupaksha. They are like the representation of the god. And because जो उनके royal documents होते थे तो उसमें जो sign होता था उसमें श्री विरूपक्षा लिखा होता था. And generally ये जो श्री विरूपक्षा था वो कन्नड़ में लिखा जाता था. They also kind of associated themselves with the deity, with the almighty, by you know adopting titles like Hindu Suratrana, which is like the Sanskritized word of the term, Arabic term, Sultan. So they were the Hindu Sultans.
Okay.
Even as these Vijayanagar rulers, they drew on the early traditions, they had their own development and innovations. Royal portraits, sculptures were you know kind of displayed in the temples. A king's visit to the temple was something that was a big occasion. It was a celebrated occasion, and he was accompanied by his nayaks, especially important nayaks of the empire. तो वो जो एक king का एक temple में visit करना जो था वो भी एक occasion माना जाता था. तो that is how they started growing, you know, they started gaining more support by the people. काफ़ी new architectural features add हुई थी विजयनगर empire के time पर, एंड वो थे राया गोपुरम्स और द रॉयल गेटवेज. सो दीज रॉयल गेटवेज वर ह्यूज एंड दे वुड एक्चुअली ड्वार्फ द टावर्स विच वुड बी अ पार्ट ऑफ द सेंट्रल श्राइन. व्हाई दीज गेटवेज वर सो एलैबोरेट एंड ह्यूज, बिकॉज सो दैट अ पर्सन कुड यू नो स्पॉट अ टेम्पल फ्रॉम अ डिस्टेंस, यू नो कि अच्छा उधर एक रॉयल टेम्पल है या वो सीक्रेट जगह है तो दूर से ही दिख जानी चाहिए. दैट इज़ वाई दे हैड स्टार्टेड कंस्ट्रक्टिंग दीज ह्यूज गोपुरम्स. दीज गोपुरम्स ऑल्सो इन अ वे शोड द पावर, द प्रेस्टीज ऑफ द किंग दैट ही वाज एबल टू यू नो गेन रिसोर्सेज टू कंस्ट्रक्ट सच ह्यूज टेम्पल्स. अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट फीचर दैट वाज एडेड वर द मंडप्स. दीज मंडप्स वर वेरी एलैबोरेट एंड दे हैड ह्यूज कॉरिडोर दैट वर कार्व्ड एंड एनग्रेव्ड विद basic engraving. There were long pillared corridors that ran around the shrine within the temple complex. So in this chapter they have given a lot of they have laid a lot of emphasis on two important temples. One is the Virupaksha temple, then is the second is the Vitthal temple. So Virupaksha temple, we've told you that he was god Shivji and who was the local deity there, and he married Pampa Devi. जो विरूपाक्ष टेम्पल है वो कहते हैं सेंचुरीज से बना है, 9th-10th सेंचुरी से उसकी फाउंडेशन ले हो गई थी, बट जो और इस्टेब्लिश और एनलार्ज हुआ था वो विजयनगर एम्पायर के इस्टेब्लिशमेंट के बाद हुआ था। जो मेन श्राइन है उसका जो सामने ऑडियंस जो हॉल है जो बनाया था वो कृष्णदेव राय ने बनाया था व्हेन ही हैड बिकम द रूलर, एंड दिस हॉल वाज डेकोरेटेड विद इंट्रिकेटली कार्व्ड पिलर्स। ही हैड ऑल्सो इन द ईस्टर्न साइड ही हैड कंस्ट्रक्टेड अ गोपुरम, एंड अगेन गोपुरम इज ऑलवेज लाइक एसोसिएटेड विद अ किंग्स पावर एंड प्रेस्टीज। फॉर एग्जाम्पल लाइक हाउ द थर्ड मुगल एम्परर अकबर व्हेन ही हैड सीज गुजरात, सो व्हेन ही केम बैक टू आगरा, आगरा के वहाँ फतेहपुर सीकरी के जब वो फतेहपुर सीकरी आ रहे थे तो उसी के पास जो शेख सलीम चिश्ती की दरगाह है उनके ही एंट्रेंस पे ही हैड कंस्ट्रक्टेड अ ह्यूज दरवाज़ा कॉल्ड बुलंद दरवाज़ा। सो दीज वर द वे ऑफ एक्सप्रेसिंग योर पावर योर प्रेस्टीज दैट यू आर अ रूलर, यू आर अ स्ट्रॉन्ग रूलर एंड यू हैव वन ओवर पीपल एंड वन ओवर डिफरेंट रूलर्स। तो ये एक तरीका होता था जैसे आप मंदिर हो चाहे वो दरगाह हो टू शो योर पावर।
Also, construction was very expensive, yeah. Especially construction of stone, not of perishable material. So only an emperor could do it, yeah. And to mark important occasions during their reign.
अब इन additions के वजह से जो central shrine था वो छोटा पड़ गया, वो that became smaller because the additions were very elaborate that you know covered the small the central shrine. These halls were used for various celebrations. तो ये जो halls थी they were used for they would keep the image of the deity and then songs were performed in front of the deity, songs, dance were performed, then also the marriages of deities were celebrated, like how Virupaksha and Pampa Devi's marriage is celebrated annually in the Virupaksha temple, and also for other celebrations were you should take place. Though in the central shrine jo image god ki rakhi jati thi that used to be there, but for these special occasions there were special images of gods you know that were kept for those special occasions ki not for everyday purposes, for everyday worship,
fancy
images, yeah. Another shrine is the Vithal temple. Vithal is a form of Vishnu and this form of Vishnu and the name is mostly famous in Maharashtra. So how did it come here to Vijayanagar Empire? Because the Vijayanagar kings had this habit of you know drawing upon various traditions of the neighboring areas to establish their imperial culture. So they drew upon various cultures. So this temple had various halls, and the most distinctive of the hall, the shrine, was that resembled a chariot. A characteristic feature of this temple is that of the chariot streets. So the streets were there and that started from the gopurams and it paved way inside the temple complex. And these streets were laid by were paved by slabs, huge stone slabs, and also it was lined by pavilions, intricately designed pavilions, so that the merchants could set up their shops. And not only the raya, the kings played an important role when it comes to construction of these temples or additions in these temples. Nayaks also played a very important role. So unka jo kaam tha fortification banane tak nahi tha, they also there were examples where they have you know introduced huge and beautifully designed gopurams and elaborate gopurams and mandaps.
The next topic is plotting palaces, temples and bazaars. Now throughout the chapter we have described the Vijayanagar Empire, where it stood, where the royal sector was, where the religious sector was, how tall the buildings could have been, how wide they were, where the pavements were, where the bazaars were. But how were we able to gather that information? Now, after Colin McKenzie did his initial survey, a lot of the information that the empire was based on was gathered through the accounts of travelers, and all of that was compiled, and that is something that gave us an idea of where a certain structure might have been, where a certain road might have been. Now, through the 20th century, the site of Vijayanagar and also Hampi was maintained by the ASI, the Archaeological Survey of India, as well as the Karnataka Department of Archaeology and Museums. In 1976, Hampi was recognized as a site of national importance. And now, as we know, Hampi is also a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Now, in the 1980s, a project was launched to document the material remains of the Vijayanagar Empire. And this was done through a variety of surveys, both extensive and intensive. काफ़ी बारीक मतलब बारीकी से काम लिया गया. ओवर 20 ईयर्स वॉज स्पेंट एंड अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल पार्टिसिपेटेड इन इट. नॉट जस्ट एन इंडियन टीम बट ऑल्सो एन इंटरनेशनल टीम ऑफ आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट्स एंड स्कॉलर्स पार्टिसिपेटेड इन डॉक्यूमेंटिंग द रिमेन्स ऑफ द विजयनगर एम्पायर. नॉट द एंटायर प्रोसेस इज ऑफ कोर्स वेरी लॉन्ग लेंथी tiresome, and of course it is something that took almost over 20 years and you know a huge team of people to gather and compile the information. One area that is mentioned in the book is that of mapping, and the book mentions how the area was studied. So the entire area was divided into squares of maybe 25 square kilometers, or larger or smaller, and then these squares were then further divided into smaller squares, which were again divided into smaller squares, and so that brought down your area of so it of course divided your work a lot, but because of that aapne itni bariki se wo within a square of maybe 2 kilometers and even less than that you are trying to excavate and gather information, that has led to the findings of a variety of structures which don't exist. So because a lot of material, a lot of secular buildings were built out of perishable materials like wood, what is remaining is are only the base structure of it, and the only evidence that this was perhaps a structure of importance was through pockets that were used to place wooden pillars. And that is something that had they not divided the land into these squares and then further divided them into smaller squares to try to excavate the area, they might have overlooked these structures. But regardless, through their painstaking work, unka matlab itna effort laga, uske through we were able to gather information on where markets stood, where the pavement leading to the market stood, where some other buildings stood, and that is how they were able to reconstruct an idea of the empire. And even then, the people that worked within this team, they have mentioned that although we are giving you an idea of what is there, we have to imagine it without the wooden pillars and the wooden beams and maybe the structures. And so what we have right now is far less than what would have been part of the Vijayanagar Empire. And even the wooden pillars or the walls or whatever wood was used was probably plastered with a variety of more relief features which don't exist, and maybe they were painted in different colors. The way if you see the Gopurams, how they are carved, and that is, there's a possibility that the wooden structures were also carved like that, but we don't have them, they don't exist for us to be able to piece them together apart from maybe our imagination.
Yeah, what we see now is just the 50 or the 60%.
Yeah
40% to 40 to 50% we've lost to time.
So what we have left is just the skeleton.
Yeah,
but the muscle and the blood and all that has been lost to time.
Questions in search of answers. So basically, buildings that have survived, they tell us about the past, they tell us about the spaces that they've used for the how they've been used by the people. When a building is constructed, the material that has been used. We get to know about the military aspect also when we see the fortification in a particular region, ki what was the military requirement of that time. What was the idea behind the person who was constructing such buildings? Also the materials that were used, the ideas, the carvings, you know, the literature that was a part of it. So ye cheeze humko answers deti hain kahin na kahin. And the builders wished how to project a particular monument, also कैसे जो कल्चरल आइडियाज़ हैं, यू नो, जो लिटरेचर, जो इन्फ्लुएंसेस हैं, उस स्प्रेड ऑफ आइडियाज़ भी हमको मॉन्यूमेंट से पता चलते हैं. और साथ में विद दैट कम्बाइंड विद लिटरेचर एंड इंस्क्रिप्शंस एंड यू नो पॉपुलर ट्रेडिशंस, दे टेल अस अबाउट दीज अनआंसर्ड क्वेश्चंस. सो दिस वाज द विजयनगर एम्पायर वेयर वी सॉ हाउ इन द तुंगभद्रा रीजन इन द नॉर्थ एंड टू द सदर्न पेनिनसुला वी फाइंड दिस Vijayanagar Empire that had various dynasties. A beautiful place called Hampi is situated there. Then you have local traditions of Pampa Devi and Virupaksha, who was a local name for Lord Shiva. And this is how the Vijayanagar Empire flourished, how Krishnadev Rai played a very important role, how the Amara Nayaka system worked and functioned, how Inner Waking depended on their services, and how it also disintegrated and completely now it's in ruins. I hope that you have liked today's episode. Please like, share and subscribe and keep watching Tareek.